passing one hand behind my back. I will dance on your...
And you'll be dead! Careful, bro!
Where have you been?
I got here as soon as I could, bro.
Oh, man, Louise Gracie! Louise Gracie!
What about Gracie?
They got Gracie! She's gone! Evan's dead! Now Gracie!
Fuck Evan, who's got Gracie?
I don't know!
So what are you talking about, bro? Where is she?
Some guy's at war with her father, I guess. I don't know!
Hey, Gracie's pretty tough.
She's a princess!
She's a tough princess.
Oh, they fucking hurt her!
Yeah, they'll have you, me, and my family to deal with.
You never liked her. You never did. You never liked anyone.
That's not true. I like her.
No, you didn't.
She's my favorite go-kart.
Oh, and what makes you so good, huh? If it wasn't for me, you'd be selling dime bags on a street corner. I made you.
Yeah, and she and Evan made you into a junkie, okay? I mean, she's not a bad person. Okay, she's not a murdering, greedy psychopath like me. She's so hard. You know, if you can get past the accent, okay? But she made you into a useless old queen, too whacked out on blowing pills to notice his business is going to shit.
Oh, here we go, huh? Here we fucking go, huh? Oh, I see it in your eyes. You're embarrassing me. You see me and think, oh, this is it. This is the moment to put me down. This is the moment when the apprentice takes over, huh? Oh, man. You think I'm done? You're not so fucking tough, Louise.
And you're not so smart, you dumb junkie. Fuck!
Yeah, fuck you, Louise!
Come on, Tony. Chill out.
Oh. Or, no, you're right. You're right. You're not the one with the problem. I am.
Tony, what the fuck are you doing?
No, I'm holding you back. I see that now. I see that now. The closest thing I've had to a son. I'm sorry, Luis. I love you. Tony. Goodbye.
Tony, come on, man.
Goodbye. I love you. Shit. Shit.
Fuck. Ah! Ah! The fuck is wrong with you, you dumb prick? Huh? Get up. Get up so I can kill you myself. Get up.
Okay. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I just couldn't take it anymore.
Come on. Get up. Get up, you old bastard.
Oh.
Huh? Let's go find Gracie, okay?
Okay. Oh.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit, Louise.
We should go and get the Ancelotti's chopper. It's just on the other side of the Booth Tunnel.
What's this chopper for?
There are some punks and dukes that might have a link to this thing. We're gonna follow them and see if they lead us to our girl.
Okay, it's a shot in the dark, but it might work.
Let's hope so.
You calm down now, T?
Of course I'm calm. I'm really calm. Why wouldn't I be calm?
I don't know. You did just point a gun at me. You nearly just shot yourself.
That? Oh yeah, I'm cool. Mellow.
Good, because we're gonna need to really hold shit together for a while if we want to survive this shit.
What do you mean? If we're going to get Gracie back?
I wasn't talking about that. I mean, I really want to get Gracie back. But at the end of the day, that ain't our main problem.
but we've got to get her back, all right?
All I'm saying is there are bigger problems we got to deal with. If Crazy came back tomorrow, we'd still be looking down the gun. We got debts. Who knows how many people want us dead? At some point, we're going to have to start getting selfish.
Who cares about us? Gracie's safety has got to be our priority. She's an innocent.
An innocent? Come on, T. But that's one of the biggest monsters in the city. He runs a family. Can he handle this?
He's blaming us, Lou.
He's doing what?
The diamonds. He says it's got something to do with the diamonds and Gracie hanging out with us. He's holding us responsible for the whole fucking mess.
What about that fucking greasy cabrón Rocco? He should be taking the shit for this. It ain't us, T.
They look after their own.
Fuck!
Shit! I just got forward a photo of Gracie from the kidnappers. The girl does not look good.
Hey, who knows? Found and gagged? Might be the look for Guido Sluss next season. Anyways, look at the bright side. At least she's alive.
Shit! You're giving me a headache! Chopper. Let's not screw it up as well.
Come on, hurry up, man.
The place we're checking out is over in Cerveza Heights.
So, D, hypothetically, what would happen if we did find Gracie? We're gonna storm in there and make these kidnappers pay?
God, no. Are you crazy?
You mean fucking crazy? That's a bit rich coming from you.
You're the one who wants to start some armed offensive on the kidnappers of a mob skipper's daughter. What's the first thing they're gonna do? You've seen the movies. They'll cap her.
Oh, they'll cap her, will they? Mr. Streetwise dangerous motherfucker. Ain't we being held responsible for this shit anyway?
Being tangentially blamed for an abduction I can just about handle. She comes back with 10 fingers, 10 toes, a smile on her face, and a curse on her lips, then we'll be fine. She gets a coup de grace after some half-cocked rescue attempt, and we're well and truly ass-fucked, and not in a good way. Prison style. Not gangbang with a boy band style.
Thank you for sharing that image with me.
My pleasure. Now, no hero shit, Lou. Promise me, this is just a reconnaissance mission.
Sir, yes, sir. Observe and report.
That's the house up there. Their car, Lou. The red one. Let's follow it. I need to fucking relax. I'm meditating on this trip. turning back on himself. I thought he was heading west.
Well, now he's heading east. We won't lose him, man. We're cool.
Come on, you dumb dukes fuck. Take us to her.
You yell loud enough, he might just hear you.
Maybe if we concentrate hard enough, we can will him to go there.
I thought you got over that spiritual shit when you stopped dating the yoga instructor.
There are things that stick with you forever.
Like the fact that he could get his ankles around his ears and he ate a lot of mung beans. That image is gonna stick with me.
You're getting too close. Pull back.
Where are these guys from? Other than Dukes, I mean.
They're an Irish operation headed by this maniac called Gerald McCreary. He's doing time in Alderney State.
Irish like those guys who robbed our bank? They could be the same ones that held me hostage.
Stranger things have happened.
What would they need a mob boss's daughter for when they got all the bank money?
How the fuck do I know? I guess greed is a powerful motivator.
I got an idea.
Great. What is it?
We stop that fuss car, we rig his balls to the battery. By the time he smells them cooking, we'll know exactly where Gracie's at.
This is a great bit of improvisation, Lou. But I think we should just follow him. Leave the torch to professionals, people in government. He's going into the tunnel. We're fucked.
He's only got two exits, T. He should come right out over by where we picked up the chopper.
Or he could hijack some other car, and we'll be sitting here waiting for him with our dicks in our hands.
Hey, my dick's in my pants, not my hand, T. And it's staying there. Let's just wait to see if he comes out.
Shit! I can't see the car! I see him! He's crossed over to Alderney! He's coming out of the booth right now!
You know how they got Gracie?
Something to do with that pink piece of shit car she had. They think the guy pretended he wanted to buy it.
She should have got suspicious the second anyone expressed interest in that thing. Actually, wait. I can see you driving a pink car, T.
Why? Because people call me gay, Tony? In that case, you probably think I've got massive sculptures of cocks in my apartment as well. Gay guys love that shit, you cliche-loving moron.
There was that one marble thing you bought.
That was art.
Yeah, giant, veiny, penis-shaped art. At least you made a profit on it. Those were the days.
Where's he going? What's he doing in the parking lot?
What's he been doing driving anywhere? We give him a moment and call it in if it feels weird.
Okay. Why does everything feel weird to me?
Because you owe money to half the city and the other half wants you dead. Paranoia is advising our situation.
Look, he's there. Just lead us back to Gracie, you fucker.
Somewhere, at least.
What street is that?
I don't know Alderney well, bro, but I think the big one's Sacramento. Call it in.
Let's head back to the helipad.
You gonna call him?
I'm texting.
Look at you, bro.
What?
Down with the kids.
You work in the business, Lou. You should know that club promoters are the first to master all new forms of communication.
Always find a new way of profiting.
If we pull this off, we'll profit. We'll get to keep our spinal cords.
Great. I like my spinal cord, bro. It would be a fucking shame to lose it.
I hope for our sake they do. See you soon, partner.
Hello.
Hola, burrito.
Rocco, how'd you get my fucking number? I don't want to talk to you.
Too bad, Mex. This line opened up just as soon as Tony took those points.
You know, Rock, your guinea ass is lower down this country's ethnic food chain than mine. So don't fucking condescend me.
Oh, I got Senora Sensitive here. Hey, look, I respect you, so I'm gonna talk straight a second. Tony's pissed a lot of people off. You need to control him.
Tony's gonna calm down as soon as you stop sending us on suicide missions.
Oh, look at my position. Some serious mulayos. You think the higher powers are gonna stop expecting envelopes from me because of the homo's midlife crisis? Doctor's notes don't cut it with these people.
Be reasonable then, Rock. Chinatown? Bahama Mamas? Those fucking bombs? That's some out of control shit, man.
No! Tony's some out of control shit. Think about what he has got you into. But if you think about it too long, then there might be no getting out of it. Comprende?
Not really, bro. Goodbye.
Get moving!
Back hey, off! I need your bike! I hope you got insurance!
Suck, man.